always think if you're looking for somewhere to feel really underprivileged, you can't go far wrong with the railway parcels office.
Well, it might have had a cousin on the railway once. She said she wouldn't tell her mum, but she did.
You shouldn't laugh at your own jokes. What sort of idiot laughs at his own jokes?
Yeah, old Billy, he loved a joke. He said a bloke was no good without a sense of humour.
Well, he certainly needed one. I saw his cousin.
Happy birthday to somebody.
Hey, I just went. That's done it. I shall feel totally rejected all day now. All right, come on, let's be having you. Come on, here. Put you in there.
But we told him, don't bang on the door, we said. It upsets the biological clocks of railway men.
There's only a railway person along in a minute. We said, after all, this is the age of the high-speed train.
Shouldn't there be smoking in here?
Smoking is allowed, idiot.
Oh, let us a fag.
Why don't you buy some?
He gave his last one to a wounded railway man before they carried him off on a stretcher in the wrong direction.
Funny. Very funny.
Yes, I believe you have a parcel from Dewhurst.
There's no train stops at Dewhurst.
Dewhurst, that's my name. I'm expecting a parcel.
How do you spell it?
P-A-R-C-A or parcel?
How do you spell Dewhurst?
Oh, D-W-H-U-R-S-T. How do you spell it?
It's not in the book.
Well, it was sent by passenger train last night to be collected this morning.
It's not in the book.
Yes, well, I can live with it not being in the book as long as it's in that pile over there.
If it was in that pile over there, it'd be in this book. Eddie!
What?
Tell him. Every parcel that comes in this office goes in this book.
Yeah?
Right?
Right.
So everything in that pile there is in this book. Right?
Wrong.
Wrong?
Well, not that pile. I ain't done that bar yet.
Oh, well. You haven't done that bar yet. What was name again?
Dewhurst.
D-E-W-H-U-R-S-T.
That's right.
This will be yours then.
Very probably.
You mean you're not sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Send a flag unfolded.
A flag? Yes, well, I'm a patriot, you see. I have a plan for putting the perfect finishing touch to the great British countryside.
You're going to paint it white?
No, of course I'm not. No, I'm going to mount this, you see, on a very, very tall flagpole on a suitable promontory.
What flag?
But a Union Jack.
What Union?
Look at him, he's like honeymooner with his gloves on.
Oh, he's not just going to eat it.
Maybe he's only going to eat the string.
Well, you've seen him, he eats everything.
I think he's only going to eat the string. He's got a great set of teeth for a man his age.
I wish I'd brought him with me.
Well, it puts you in mind of primitive man at his breakfast.
I wonder what they used to have for breakfast, primitive man. Something that went snap, crackle and shriek.
Oh, come on, we'll take it home and get a knife. Come on. No, come on, I don't want it all soggy. You're supposed to raise a lower flag, not ring it out. Give it
to me. Hey, I'm a
sandwiches, I see. Come on, let's get it out and get a knife.
Get out!
I wouldn't have walked home with him, you know, not like that. I mean, it was very embarrassing. People would have stared at him. You don't expect to see anyone with his own tame lunatic performing in the streets these days. They might have thrown pennies, you know.
It's no good. I can't do it here.
I want some good beer. behaviour down here. Do I make myself clear? It would be unwise at this juncture to incur the displeasure of the management. This could become a regular booking. I mean, they have to meet somewhere once a fortnight, and it might as well be here.
Who has to meet somewhere once a fortnight?
The bullocks. Mother Nature told her of bullocks.
Oh, come on.
It's true. You've heard of the buffs, the lions, the elks. But we've got the bullocks.
The soup, sweet and cold buffet.
To be served in a private room where they can first perform their ancient secret ceremonies.
What kind of ceremonies?
Short ones, I hope, if they want their soup keeping warm.
Secret ones. Nobody ever sees their ceremonies unless it's a bullock. I was talking to their first arm.
What?
First arm. He's a senior officer at the lodge. He told me their ceremonies are shrouded in mystery. He thinks they go back to time immemorial.
Like when they first began the Humber Bridge.
It's an excuse if you ask me to keep the women out.
Well, they are, you see. Nobody's all that.
How did you get them here?
Establishment. Nobody actually hijacked them.
Look, I see you had to lock the door to keep them in.
That was to keep you lot out.
You just looked up and there they were, 28 bullocks.
They're in between premises owing to redevelopment. But it made a lovely job of the room, though. It's all decked out with wall hangings and banners. Their first horn, he goes down with two of his acolytes and he supervises every detail.
Yeah, then stops off at the pub for an hour with you.
We were only finalising arrangements.
Leaving me with 28 cold buffies.
Yeah, but what exactly do they do?
Well, they band together for mutual brotherhood and charitable purposes.
They get plastered two nights a week and have a lunch once a fortnight.
Unofficially, their first horn confided in me that they are something of a power in racing pigeon circles.
You don't want too much of that in your upstairs line, now, do you?
It's nothing. They've gone quiet again. It's not disturbing anybody.
What, 28 cold buffets dancing on the ceiling?
Well, they never said a word about dancing. We've no license for dancing.
It's not dancing.
Eh? Oh.
It's not dancing. That's not dancing.
They're just banding together for mutual brotherhood and charitable purposes.
You'll have to go up and have a word.
It's not dancing. You can't interrupt. It's all part of the ceremony.
Come on, now.
They're powering racing pigeon circles.
Yeah.
It's cubic.
I mean, upstairs with the bullocks. Get away round the back. Hey, I think they're a load of daisies. They keep walking about and jumping in front of each other. Like this. Who's a pretty bullock then? Congratulations, Ivy. That's a lovely puppy you put up there. I bet three old me.
There's Mummy. That's going to breeze up to this boat and ask this fella, a complete stranger, if you can borrow his flagpole.
It's not his flagpole. It belongs to the sea cadets. They've been disbanded. They don't need it.
What are you asking him for, then?
Because he used to be in charge of the sea cadets.
Until they were all found drunk in charge of a minesweeper.
Has Mummy known this fella, then?
We're not complete strangers. We're both professionals. Former fighting men. We've both known the loneliness of command. Him in charge of a destroyer. We as Corporal Signwriter. Deputation to see the Commodore. Permission to come aboard, sir. Deputation to see the Commodore. Permission to come aboard, sir.
Nobody ever does come here.
Who are they?
How the devil
capture that.
Listen, Foggy, I'm not absolutely convinced that we timed this right.
Well, we can't leave now, he's seen us.
I don't think he'd mind, honestly, don't think he'd mind.
That bird's got a guilty conscience. And she's got a mole on her left.
What's that?
Still, it's not a pleasant thought to toy with while sitting in the back of a room. by smoking a nugget.
It's a bit like falling under a rope divider. Still, I'll say this much for Nora. She's very skilled at being horrible.
She has a flair for it.
Why do swallows ever pull a muscle?
Why?
They can't always be darting about lyrically. Maybe those that we see on telephone wires are feeling stiff. We think that they're resting, but maybe there's some poor little devil up there thinking, I'm going to fall, I'm going to fall.
Commodore's expressed a wish to see the flag being raised.
Get the feel of the thing, what? You'll be up there in a tricky. Get those bullocks champions to help you.
It's very kindly offered to let you take the car.
Yes, take the car, take the car.
Say, I'll fetch the flag then. Drive over to yonder hill and stroll up to the top of the pole and raise the jolly old flag. It's a Commodore and I will stay here and see what it looks like. Well, off you go. You know what I wanted.
I know exactly where they want it. Stare at your legs. Me
doesn't. He stays at pigeon photographs. Well, go on. Turn your backs, all of you. Go on, turn round.
Hey, wouldn't it be simpler if you just come down?
I'm not stepping off this table till you've found that mouse. It's behind that chair. Don't you like to mind that?
Okay, she's always seen mine.
How big was it, Mother?
Oh, much bigger than that.
Oh, no, I can't step on it.
With eyesight as bad as that.
Well, if it's got bad eyesight, Wally, don't hurt it if you find it.
Well drilled little team you've got there to us.
Yes, it's taken time, but I flatter myself that if I tell them to climb that hill, they will climb that hill without a murmur.
Damn fine job they've done that. We're dead in like weasels.
It's a dream I had.
Big moment for you, is it? I know how you feel.
It's been almost an obsession.
Quite. I felt just the same about the landlady of the feathers.
You know how hard it is to force your vision on a cynical world.
Oh, indeed, sport. Well, there she goes.
Drama Daytime. Stay with us for more of your favorites.